Welcome back to Character Select and the final episode of XCOM Enemy Within. It is February 3rd. XCOM 2 comes out in 2 days from this recording date. I've got to finish this game. So, I'm not really interested in chip transfers and all that stuff. We're probably going to be cutting some stuff out of this because we have to get to the finale and then do the final mission. But suffice to say, the temple ship has shown up over Earth. It's the big purple thing that you kind of saw on the other side there. I don't know why I can't... Yeah, see? There it is. Temple ship has shown up. Bad shit's about to go down. And the alloy cannon is complete. So, you know, great. Codename Avocet. So, machining the alloy was an arduous process, leaving us with limited options as to what it could be used for. Though we considered the alien alloy's density a benefit, one that made it ideal for use as an advanced form of projectile ammunition, the material proved so dense that it ate directly into the weapon's barrel, making it useless after a single firing. So, they've developed a barrel sleeve made from the alloy, calling it now operational. We have ample time to study the effects of its design. Though similar to a traditional shotgun configuration, because of its specialized ammunition, the alloy cannon is substantially more powerful and deadly. Testing on targets made up of a modified ballistic gel proved pointless, as the targets were completely penetrated by the alloy munitions, despite an average thickness of 2 meters. Yeah, it's murderous. I love that thing. Okay, we... Shit, I need 4 more weapon fragments. Fuck. We gotta research the ethereal device.
I accept the fact that there could be risks involved in studying this new alien device, but the enemy leaves us with no other choice.
And we definitely have to get 4 more weapon fragments, so it sounds like we're probably gonna have to do at least one mission. But see what happens here.
Transfer complete.
Never mind, that was quick. Codename Skylight. Having learned a great deal about the hyperwave beacon and its associated interdimensional signaling capabilities, we believe this newly discovered device confirms our suspicions about this technology and takes it a step further. The Psylink, as it is now being called, appears to provide a direct link to the psionic network used by the aliens for field communications. Although we are treading into an area of highly theoretical science, we believe there is a strong indication that the aliens function under a collective consciousness, a form of social organization akin to a hive mind as seen in various species of insects found on Earth. It wasn't until our first interaction with the ethereal species of alien that we were able to understand the scope of the psionic abilities we had previously been exposed to. Although we've only scratched the surface in terms of developing psionic abilities within a human subject, we've now theorized that it may be possible to join the alien's consciousness, to tap into their hive mind by successfully activating this device. However, in order to ensure the safety of XCOM's headquarters, we'll need to construct a chamber that minimizes the potential risk to the rest of the facility during the activation progress. As it so happens, 2 of our brightest young minds, a team of brothers, have already conceived of just such a facility appropriate to this task. If we manage to locate a soldier with an aptitude for psionics and find a means to develop these abilities further, I believe it'll be only a matter of time before we succeed in activating the device and finding the source of this invasion. It's called the Gollop Chamber because XCOM was made by 2 guys called the Gollop Brothers. Julian Gollop was one of them anyway. So the original XCOM way back when. Ghost armor is cool. I don't need it. I really want to get to the end of this game. We do need Psy armor though. So let's build that or research that. Thank God for ridiculously fast Psy research. Codename Witchwood. Blah blah blah. It's not as strong as Titan armor, but it should more than compensate by providing a significant boost to our soldiers' psionic abilities. As we seek to discover the source of the alien's collective unconsciousness. And I don't want to do the fusion lance. I'm going to do ghost armor because I really need more weapon fragments. Need to go to engineering.
Down to the wire here. Now that we've backed the aliens into a corner, I think we'll see what they're really made of. Personally, I expect nothing short of pure desperation in their resistance. They've invested too much to go down without a fight.
Fun fact, we haven't backed them into any kind of corner.
We need to start working on the housing for this device as soon as possible.
Ah, shit, I haven't excavated. Fuck.
We should be making every effort to provide a secure location for its storage.
I do need to build by items, though. What do we get? What do we got? I need heavy plasmas. Actually, I only need two alloy cannons. Done. Round of psionic testing is complete. Both James Captain Australia Space is gifted, as is Captain Matt Reaper. Go fucking figure. Jesus Christ, how many soldiers do I have that are fucking psionically active? Fuck me. Alright, before I forget, you are fired, as are you, and you, and you, and you. Alright, we're down to the originals. Well, I guess we could get rid of these guys too, but yeah, whatever.
Goliath.
Jesus, so many people are fucking psionically active. It's amazing. Never happens that way. I think that's everybody. Is there anybody? Uh-oh, we haven't tested Kylan. Might as well do that. Scan for activity. Advanced flight. Yes, that's good. But it's not the weapon fragments that I need. Come on, guys. I need weapon fragments. Please. Please give me weapon fragments. Ghost armor is cool. You can basically turn invisible whenever you want. But the Fusion Lance is a vehicle weapon. It's the strongest weapon that you can get. It shoots down a battleship in 2 shots, which is pretty fucking amazing. I really want the guided fusion launcher, though, and I only need 4 more weapon fragments. God damn it. You want scope, you'll give me 3 engineers. Eh.
Excavation complete.
Ooh, good. Build facilities, build facility. Gollop chamber is the priority. In construction, go back to engineering, and I need to build some armor. You're only ever going to need 1 suit of psi armor. You can get more, but it's not that big a deal. Ghost armor, we're going to build one of those. Excellent. We now have built literally everything that's worth building. Good times.
Contact detected.
Small objective scout target. Shoot the shit out of that thing. Get me some weapon fragments, goddammit. Ka-doom.
We're in pursuit.
Damn straight we are.
Closing on target.
Oh, it's a small one too. Sweet. There's gonna be an ethereal on it, because you know. One shot.
One shot, one kill.
Ethereal, Muton Elite, and the Seekers, but there's only 7, which means that's 1 ethereal. 2 Seekers, 4 Mutons. I'm okay with that, actually. Might also get a chance to capture some heavy plasmas, but I don't want to capture them. I want to blow them up.
Our soldiers returned home safely, and they recovered a significant amount of the meld substance for our research. Excellent work.
More importantly, we got 18 weapon fragments. Much more useful. Which allows us to go to research, start new research project, Guided Fusion Launcher. Which takes 6 days? God damn it. Okay. We're almost done. How long is that Gollop Chamber going to take? 14 days. Okay. So, we got to wait for that to be done. Excellent. I do love having more firestorms. That goes up. Alright, good. Back. Can't transfer while it's arming. Okay. Alright, so. 3 more days till psi testing, 4 more days till guided fusion launcher, 12 more days to the Gollop chamber.
Contact
detected.
Ah, shit. On the one hand, I kind of want to capture an ethereal. On the other hand, I'm so close to being finished. Council report in 16 days. We're going to ignore this.
Commander, by ignoring these UFO contacts...
I know we're putting the UFO contacts at risk.
Network at risk.
Kylan does not have the gift. That's a shame. That's everybody, I think. Everybody's been tested. Yeah, everybody's been tested. Which means that out of 12 possible candidates, we got 5 psionic troopers. That's astonishing. That's borderline insanity. Oh, fuck. Are you kidding me?
We have multiple reports of new abductions in progress. The locations are marked on the hologlobe.
I don't have time for this nonsense. The panic will go up. They're not giving me anything useful either. I could really use money. Yeah, we're gonna ignore it. We're gonna ignore it. That's not what I wanted to check. Visit the Great Market. This is the time to sell all of our corpses, because we don't need them anymore. I mean, you can make things with some of these corpses, but none of them are particularly useful. We don't have enough chrysalids to make more chitin armor, so that's fine. We're not going to be making any more UFOs. Or firestorms, because I'm pretty sure we have one for each frickin'... one for each frickin' continent now, so... Yes, I know, Bradford. You're going to be mad. Thank you. Codename Tunguska. Blaster launcher available for manufacture. So basically, the blaster launcher is more powerful than a rocket launcher and cannot miss. And can fire around corners. And they're absurdly expensive. 9 days for the colony. 9 days for the colony. I only need one blaster launcher, but... I just sold my flight computers! No! God damn it! Fuck! There's no point in going there because they're not gonna help. Oh shit! It's a battleship!
Enemy is padlocked.
So battleships are late game.
Nearing strike range.
Look how big this thing is compared to the fucking Firestorm. And it still shot it down, too. That's pretty fucking impressive. Mectoid, Sectoid, Muton, Berserker, Cyberdisc, Muton, Muton, Elite, Ethereal. No Sectopod? Okay. Sure, let's fucking do this shit. The hell was that? Weird. So none of these guys have Overwatch, which is good. Yo, shit. Wait, you said there wasn't a Sectopod! Motherfucker! I count on you, Hyperwave Decoder. I count on you to tell me certain fucking things.
Time to disappear.
For fuck's sake.
All mission objectives completed.
Fuck me. It should not have been as close as it was, except that there were Sectopods! Seven days until I'm back to fully mission capable. Alright, so just in case I skip past all that, bad things happened. But at least I got the flight computers that I desperately, desperately needed. Because now I can build the blaster launcher. which is just insanely expensive for what it is. But I like it, so. Alright. Now we're just waiting for that Golub chamber to be completed.
Commander, we've got another transmission coming.
Please
in from the
tell
council.
Me no. Why? No, I don't care. Golub chamber completed! We're at the fucking endgame! As long as literally everybody is full health, then we should be fine.
Golub chamber online.
Wait, is everybody? Everybody's up to 100%. The only problem that I have is that I don't have a colonel level sniper, which makes the final mission a lot easier. I do have you, but you're not quite good enough. Alright. Build, no, build items. Plasma pistol. So now we can click on Golub Chamber and end the game. I think that's what we're going to have to do. Because if the month ends, which happens in 5 days, pretty much like 17 council people are going to leave, so that would be bad. Use the Ethereum. Alright. Fingers crossed that we can do this. Let's fucking do it.
This is it. Once our volunteer enters the chamber, there is no turning back. This is what we've been working towards this whole time. We likely will not be able to make any developments beyond this point.
Basically, it's saying once you do this, you can't go back. Sonara, you're going to be the volunteer.
With each of our major victories, we have encountered incrementally more powerful aliens. After the first alien craft was shot down, they began a campaign of terror. The alien forces were led by a sectoid commander, a powerful psionic creature. Upon capturing the hyperwave beacon, we detected a cloaked ship carrying a being of incredible psionic power. Having captured the device it sacrificed itself to protect, an immense alien ship has now appeared within our atmosphere. We can only assume that a being of even greater psionic power is on board this vessel. We have already pushed human evolution so far, and I fear where the next step will take us. But our enemy leaves us with no other choice. A new type of weapon is required.
At long last. You have succeeded where we have failed.
Assault the temple ship. We can't scan for UFO activity anymore. It's literally, we have to do this. The temple ship has appeared. Now is our chance. You have to bring Sonara along because she's the volunteer and therefore the most important person. Lane, I'm sorry, I'm not bringing you on this one. What are your skills? I should have taken Rocketeer. God damn it.
Blaster launcher.
Hmm. need for the arc thrower. So we're gonna bring a nanofiber with us. Messed up a little bit there. He does talk about the voice that's talking to Sinara does have some stuff to say about the alien races. So.
On the move.
Oh, and Sinara has a new ability. It's called Rift. It's murderous. I don't know if it actually shows up here. There it is. Rift does more damage against targets with low will and reduced damage against targets with high will. 4-turn cooldown. Only get it for this map.
J'y suis déjà.
Orders confirmed. Moving out.
Here we go. Okay, what's happening here? Don't do that to me. Okay, thanks for zooming all the way out on that. So, basically what we're learning here is that the Ethereals experimented on everything that we're about to encounter. For some as yet unknown purpose. What? How is that a dash?
Hi, buddy.
shoot you right in the noggin.
Fresh.
Heading out.
I don't think I can actually see those cyber discs. I think they're just kind of actually. Cyber discs are in fact alive, but they're not capable of higher thought anymore.
Moving out.
It's kind of disturbing.
Double time.
Oh yeah, and they don't leave corpses anymore. They just disappear. You gonna move or you gonna fire? You're gonna fire. Come on, big hit, no whammy. Stop! Thank you! Let's have Mal shoot that. No, let's have
affirmative.
Tyler. Shoot the shit out of this.
Take it care of.
That Cyberdisc has Overwatch, which is not good. Bullshit, you take a reaction shot. Bullshit, you hit me!
Notify engineering of possible repairs. Almost out of ammo.
Yeah, пошёл.
This is the only mission where I'm willing to lose troops if it means that I can win. And even then, I'm going to be very hesitant. What the fuck? Stupid aiming angles. How far can you send this? Shot is blocked. Alright. Let's cover them in smoke then.
Clouds away!
Mind merge.
Any view from here?
probably aren't. Oh. Hey, V, kill it, please. Fuck you, V! I'm supposed to kill it.
Shot failed to connect.
Really? Went down with them. Strange and wrong. Wrong and strange. Fine. You actually want your grenade this time? And hit what I'm telling you to hit? There we go. Okay. Alright. Hedra, I want you to move over here.
I'm on my way.
So that Sinara can heal you. She heals 10 hit points.
Easy now, soldier.
Then move
moving
up.
To position.
This battle is unique in that the enemies are always, always in the same spots, but it doesn't matter because it's still very difficult. They're literally going to encounter every single alien that can be that it's possible to encounter. But it also means that you can advance without worrying about cover in some cases. If you know what's coming. Why did I do that? Why don't you have a plasma pistol? God damn it, I forgot to give you a plasma pistol. You can go up through the middle, and in fact, that's actually a good idea. Let's go up through the middle. You and Mal. So, I'm pretty sure I know what's coming. Mal needs to reload, too. As does Hedra.
Heading there now. Back online.
10-4.
Doop, 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 doop. Why do I keep keeping you with a pistol? Because I'm an idiot.
10-4.
It occurs to me that giving somebody with the gene mod for jumping a jetpack is probably a little excessive. Alright, before I forget.
The new one faces a great fear and an equally great disappointment. When their organic form failed to evolve, it was given the strength of a machine, creating this merciless, fearless killer, a fate worse than death.
So they looked at those aliens and said, you guys refuse to evolve the way that we want you to, so now we're going to graft a whole bunch of machinery onto you. Big fucking dick.
Heading out.
Also, I'm so glad that you finally earned that promotion there, Tyler. Good job. We'll get right back on that after we're done with this mission. You'll be good for the next one. Always rapid fire. And when it doesn't work, it's still a good idea. Because of the law of probabilities.
I'm on the move.
Something, something. Pretty sure.
ET in sight. Yeah. Engaging.
Shit, she's...
They're flanking my position!
That'd be great if they were both next to each other, but they're not. If I were to launch a grenade, would it hit both of you guys? Nope.
Thank you.
HQ.
Цель уничтожена.
Moving out.
Please to kill. Kill. Fuck your cover. Got hit by a particle rifle.
Neutralized.
Can you just rip his mind apart, please? Chrysalis! Thanks.
In the most unsavory of beings, they were little more than insects when their uplift began, and in their failure, became the most dangerous of predators, incapable of direction, understanding. They were deemed fit only to breed and die.
Rift.
Is as we head out.
Oh yeah, they really like that. He's no longer a threat, as is this stick bag. Can't continue until you kill all the aliens. There's actually something blocking you right there. They're so pleased with everything that I've done. Trying to fight them off. Also, I'm not sure if that rift is going to hurt me if I go through it, so I'm not sure I want to try.
Back is high.
Go. But anybody that's paying attention knows that there's still a few aliens that we have to kill first. We've killed sectoids, we've killed floaters, we've killed chrysalids, we've killed cyberdisks. That leaves mutons, sectopods. We probably have to kill a mectoid, but I don't know if they actually changed this mission to account for the mectoid. Probably did, just my fucking luck, you know? Oh yeah, Thin Man. So what they're saying is that psionic powers are rare. Somebody that's able to use it is an oddity as opposed to something to be celebrated. Something they want to uplift races that have the gift while also having a perfect slash fine physical form, which apparently humanity has. And they're really happy about that.
Affirmative, Commander.
You can actually stop flying.
Jetpack on deck. 10-4. Stepping off.
I actually want to gather everybody together. We're better as a team than we are separately. Except for me and Hedra over here. Do you have immunity to... Damn it, I don't know. Don't know if Psy Armor gives you the immunity to poison. Poor bastard.
Готово.
Headed there now.
Actually, now that I think about it, I am going to walk down there, aren't I?
Yes, I am! Oh, and Seekers. We're probably going to have to fight Seekers.
Solid copy, Commander.
Thumbs up.
Super glad about that. Hopefully I have battle scanners enough to detect them all.
On y va.
You have Titan armor, so you're immune to poison. But you can't even get to the poison cloud this turn, so whatever. Oh, and if the volunteer dies, Sonara dies, then game over. FYI. That's why I'm being super cautious with her. It's not worth the, not worth taking chances. She needs to survive to the last room.
Headed there now.
Everybody take the opportunity to reload if you can. Overwatch. Reload. 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 If they're willing to wait for me, I'm willing to reload whenever I get the chance. This part's always fucking tense and I hate it. There's so much riding on this mission. Especially on an Iron Man save. Although I did find out something interesting about the Iron Man save. If I fail this mission, even though it's saving every turn, it will go back and allow me to start the whole mission over again from the beginning. Which is also something I don't want to do, so you know. This isn't that room. No, it's not that room.
I'm rolling.
There's a specific room that I'm really concerned about. So they're really cool, but they're not psionically active either. And that makes them useless.
Heading to that location.
I'm just gonna go back here. See if I can pull them in. See if I can convince them of the errors of their muton ways. Or come on, now it's here. Come on. Come on. Damn it, Hedra, come on. Ugh. Ugh.
I'm on it, Commander.
To quote a JonTron, ugh.
Launching proximity mine.
Hi, Berserker.
How's it going?
Oh, it didn't even hit them? Bullshit. Yeah, they all have frickin' plasma rifles. Opposed to light plasmas. Down you go.
Hostiles pacified.
Interesting. Alright, Sonara. You need to actually move, and then shoot. Yeah, and then shoot. Yeah. Rawr! Take
take some steps. Now I have the boobs over here. He says, hey buddy. No ticket. No win. Where did he? That's dumb. He disappeared before he could murder his face off. It's not nice at all. I don't like that. Really? We'll shoot him again.
Targeting system malfunction.
Lucky's fucking mute on this side of the galaxy.
Dead and gone.
Got it covered.
Probably up there. Still. Nothing? No? Hello? Anybody? Oh, I should have had you reload. Fuck.
Je bouge.
The good news is, I don't think I actually have to deal with Muton Elites. Because they're only in the last room. The last room is kind of a special case. You're invisible, so... You lucky son of a bitch! How in the fuck did you even... I don't know if you have Overwatch, so I'm gonna kill you. Fire the explosive green goos.
Heading to that location.
Can you heal? Yes, you can. Do it. As for Fat Paula here.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Wee. Love that jump. I don't know why. Probably because it's amazing. Damn it, Tyler.
Moving.
Guess we're just gonna have to go stupid. Oh no, you have a 100% chance to hit. Just kill him. Or, you know, mostly kill him. I mean, I guess that's moderately successful, but, you know, not.
Confirmed. Closing on target position now.
Oh, I still have a shot. Cool. Ripped your mind apart. Alright. I know what's in the next room. Anybody that's played this mission before also knows what's in the next room. It sucks.
Moving.
It sucks so much. I really want to make sure I have full ammo before I go. Full ammo and a V Roboto. In retrospect, I probably should have made V a mech, but oh well. I think there was a reason
position
I didn't.
Confirmed.
Call exactly what I
wanted. Good to go.
Roger that. I'm ready. Headed there now. Green to go.
Green to go, Captain. Commander.
Affirmative.
Captain Commander. This next room really sucks in Enemy Unknown. For reasons. But if I put you up here, will that tell me what's in there? It sure as fuck will!
Oh,
doesn't even do that much damage to them. The Rift, the most powerful ability in the game, doesn't do that much damage to them. Also known as AKA Bullshit. Oh, wait, you had Overwatch, didn't you? Whoops. Good job with that Overwatch, buddy. Your help is greatly appreciated. We're actually gonna get Malhavi down there as soon as possible. So that he can fuck him up with his electropod. This is the only mission in the game where it's possible to encounter... Oh, are you fucking kidding me? Where it's possible to encounter more than one sectopod. The only mission.
Deploying mine.
So of course they give you two right in the middle, right in the main room. Do you have cover there? Oh, you have high cover, even better. And you're concealed. Super fantastic, Snoss. 100% chance of, oh, 95% chance of a critical. Are we gonna get it? Oh, we are. Nice. Of course, that exposes you. It's fine.
On the move.
Depends on his hit chance. 66. Ooh. Do it. But yeah, if we can get Malhavik in place next to the other one, then it's an easy kill. It's just getting him there. That might be a little difficult.
Poursuivez-les.
Poursuivez-les.
Bien, chef.
As much damage as you can. Or no damage at all. Damn, 9 points of damage? I will take that. His main cannon sucks. Also grants him free Overwatch if he doesn't use it again. If he does use it again, he can use it twice in one turn. Damn it, now. Killing me here, buddy. He's gonna shoot a Hedra. No, he's gonna shoot at me! Ah! Ooh, that main cannon. Fucking hell. This can be a little tense if you don't have a lot of health, which thankfully I do, but... 3 damage. 3 damage from the most powerful standard rifle in the game. It's kind of bullshit.
With me, guys.
Please don't get shot. Damn it now. Now he's mostly dead. We're almost done. We're almost done.
Disabled by EMP.
Fuck you.
Affirmative,
Quick, somebody ask him if he wants some more. I think you've had enough. Oh, heavy mutines. Or mutine elites. So whatever it is that they want, they're trying to do, they're saying that we will help them do it. I don't think they understand exactly what it is that we're doing here, but either way, I'm really not inclined to help them.
Je suis déjà.
Je suis déjà là! Only problem is Mal is seriously injured and is out in the open. Overwatch? You gonna do Overwatch? Okay, you moved there to do Overwatch. Weird. Okay. Mal, do yourself a fucking favor because you have 4 hit points left. Get the fuck back here. Don't trigger Overwatch.
Aye, aye, Commander. Come on, time to cowboy up.
Cowboy up, motherfucker!
Since
Hedra's also kind of injured. This is actually a bad idea, putting everybody together like this, but I think we're far enough away that they can't throw a grenade, so... So that gives us some leeway.
Moving out. On the move.
Right, I have to remember that. You have blaster rockets.
Let's rock.
I had to use that at least once in this playthrough. So wait, who sees that guy? Nobody sees that guy. That's weird.
Rhythm your grips.
God damn it. It's not where I wanted you to move, but alright, whatever. You can't run and gun yet. He's got Overwatch, which would be bad because you don't have lightning reflexes. You have close combat. They're close and personal. Pretty sure if I run away, it's going to end just as badly. Have you ever said I was a smart man? Did you miss? No, he hit. Ow, ow, ow. God damn it. Don't worry, you've got a ridiculous amount of accuracy on this guy. Jab and touch someone. Also, it's interesting that they fire their heavy plasmas like 3 shots, and we just fire a stream of murder. Sure why that is.
On it.
Also, the Ethereals don't really understand the concept of individuals, hence why they're calling Sonara the new one, but they're referring to everybody. They assume that everybody is the same person. They're wrong, obviously, but... Alright. If I can clear this guy out, then we're done and we're ready to go. This is the final chamber. Wait. Yeah, that's the final chamber. Okay.
On avance à la vitesse de la mort.
What's up, buddy?
Sortez en enfer.
I just shot you with alien parts.
Moving out.
Alright, this is it. This is the last chance to win. This can either be the easiest fight in the game or the hardest if you have a Colonel Sniper within the zone, which we didn't actually get in the zone. In the zone basically means that if you're a sniper and you kill somebody, we want double tap. There's two. In the zone means that if you're a sniper and you kill somebody, you get another shot. As long as you keep killing people with shots, you can keep shooting. The other option, double tap, means that you get to fire twice. As long as you don't move. Which is also kind of brutal. Double tap with really high accuracy makes the final room easy. In the zone with really high accuracy can make the final room easier. But I don't have a Colonel level sniper, so we're going to have to do this a different way. And the Rift is not going to help me on that one.
10-4.
I do, however, have an invisible sniper. I'm wondering if that'll work.
confirmed. Closing on target position now.
Also, you can see the temple ship is flying above the South Atlantic.
Приказ понял.
The trick with this is to get as close as possible without going over. Take another turn.
This? Oh, it's gonna hurt.
Thanks, Sid. Everybody's pretty much full health. And I've still got rockets. So yeah, blaster launcher, I can move this wherever I want, and it has 100% chance of hitting. It's awesome. I love it. I'm actually gonna leave you there if that's the case. So the blaster launcher is going to get fired in the last round. Seems appropriate.
There now.
Here we go. Oh, damn. We're not far enough in yet. Excellent.
Roger, tracking.
You're invisible, so. How far can I shoot that blaster launcher? That's pretty good. I'd rather have you on the other side.
Affirmative.
There's actually a corridor here. It's hard to see. Maybe I can... Oh. They cut it out so that you have unobstructed view, but there's actually a corridor here, which is why there's one pathway through. Why is that as far as you can move?
C'est parti!
Now the problem is, if I go too far and I trigger them, then I'm fucked because I don't have any movement left. So you're just gonna go right here for now, because you have a lot of movement. Watch. Alien activity. This could be it, this could be the last turn. He's up there. That's where he is. Okay. I completely muffed on the layout of the room. There he is.
We who were cast out, we who were told to flee,
So they're claiming that they're doing this for our own benefit. To protect us against something worse. That's not fucking terrifying at all. And he just has... he's the uber ethereal. He has ridiculous amounts of HP, and he has 40 fucking defense. It's bullshit. And he just reflected the attack, so that's great. Would have hit. Now does 3 damage to Mal. Oh, it still did 2 damage to him. Sweet. Oh, it did 4 damage. Okay. Don't want to shoot you guys. This is a case of shooting the final boss. If you can kill the Uber Ethereal, you win. But he reflected it again! Bullshit! What you can't see, bitch. Mm-hmm. So here's the blaster launcher. I kind of want to curve it just to show, but it's not going to work. So.
Target locked.
The hard choices to make. That's why we're XCOM.
What the hell is happening?
The ship itself is behaving like a dying star, becoming a black hole. At this distance, the Earth will be consumed.
Central, I'm bugging out. The package is not on board. Waited as long as I could, sir.
Sir, the alien ship is in motion.
What direction? What direction?
Up.
Overall score, 30,000. We won in 210 days, which is 85 days less than the world average. We won 46 battles and we lost none. We killed 530 aliens. We only lost 2 soldiers. 2 soldiers. three, because we lost Fen, we lost Savin, and we lost Sonara at the end. We kept all of our funding countries, we didn't lose a single one. We cleared the alien base in 113 days, which is faster than the world. We got the ethereal device in 185 days, and we got a psionic soldier in 170 days. Oh look, more stuff. Average shot percentage 66. Average damage per shot. One shot kills 275. Nice. We only hired 6 soldiers. OTS is officer training school. Days until first colonel, 113 days. Days spent in infirmary, 273 days. We only shot down 8 UFOs. We built 5 firestorms, though. Man, we did everything faster than the world average. We got 56 scientists. We didn't build a single lab. We captured almost every single alien species. The only one we didn't capture was an ethereal, because at that point I didn't care anymore. Constructed 20 facilities, built only one workshop, got 8 adjacency bonuses, 15 foundry projects completed. We got a lot of money. We spent a lot of money. We got a lot of Illyrium. We used a lot of it. Gray market sales? A lot. Jesus. Continent bonuses, all of them. We did lose a satellite, though. That was kind of tricky. I've never lost a satellite before this game. 17 days until our second satellite. 61 days until our third. Oh, boy. So that's XCOM. In the end, we succeeded. But God knows that there are questions unanswered. Who tried to uplift the Ethereals? Why did that fail? Why did they leave the Ethereals alone? And why were the Ethereals so desperate to succeed and please their creators by doing the same thing? Maybe that'll be answered in XCOM 2. I don't know. All I know is that everybody survived except for Fen, Sonara, and Savin. And the 12 soldier challenge, or the 14 soldier challenge, was a success despite the fact that I had way too many snipers and heavies. Thank you very much for watching, and hopefully we'll have XCOM 2 up shortly. Maybe. I'm interested to see where it goes. Bye.